Pokemon Sword and Shield has broken its street date. My name is Cassius Kent, and everything about that game is leaking online right now. Hi everyone. I know that I said I wasn't excited for Pokemon, and for all intents and purposes, I am not. That's why I'm so excited about these leaks, because it's given me a reason to care about the game, because before, wasn't that interested. The new Pokemon actually all look kinda great. The starters actually look kinda great. So we're gonna get into that today. I want to make two separate videos, one talking solely about the starters, one how I feel about them and who I think is gonna be good, and the rest of the Pokemon that they revealed. There are still Pokemon being discovered as the person who got the game early plays through the game, but the fact remains, it's insane how everything is just out there now. The game comes out in 2 weeks, and I wanna know who did it, and if that person is gonna disappear soon, because Nintendo is notorious for making people disappear. Back when X and Y was leaked, got the street, they sent someone to this man's house, and he was like, hey y'all, I'm sorry, I can't talk about the game anymore. And we never heard from him again. I'm assuming that he is still in the dungeon to this day. But let's jump right into it. The three starters, the final evolutions have been leaked and they are humanoid. Oh, also before I continue, if you care about spoilers, it's far beyond any reason how you've made it a minute and 30 seconds into this video, but I will be talking about the final evolutions of the starters. If you don't want to know, don't watch the rest of the video. Thanks for your patronage, thank you for watching, thank you for listening. Until next time, I will see you. However, if you care and you want to know, you want to see the new starters, if on evolution, maybe help push you towards that which starter you were going with if you were on the fence. So, with no restraint on spoilers, let's get into it, starting with Cinderace, the fire-type Pokemon. It is a straight fire-type, which is nice to see. We haven't had a generation with straight fire, water, and grass-type Pokemon, so it's been, I believe, since second gen, where there was no subtype, because in first gen, you know, there was fire flying, and second was straight fire, but third was fire fighting, fourth was fire fighting, fifth was fire fighting, sixth was fire psychic, seventh was fire dark. So the other generation is being a return to form in the true, pure-type Pokemon, which is nice to see, honestly. Cinderace could have easily been a fire fighting type Pokemon, but it also could have been a fire electric type Pokemon, which I would have personally liked to see. Sure, it still would have had all the fire type weaknesses, and the pure fire isn't actually that great, but it's a lot better than fire fighting. The less weaknesses you have, the better. And right off the bat, I really like Cinderace's design. I wouldn't say worried, but I really like how he looks like a professional sports. I think that's what they were going for with Spore Bunny's entire line. He looks like an athlete. And I'm very appreciative of that as someone who played, you know, American soccer, you know, football, the proper football. I am glad that they went with this direction with the design. It looks like someone who would be a forward on a football team, on a European football team. I like the color scheme. The color scheme is really good. I'm actually surprised at how good the color scheme is. My only gripe with this line of Pokemon in general is that Pokemon seem to be pushing away from designing actual monsters, actual pocket monsters, and more humanoid monsters, because all three starters, they all stand upright, they're bipeds, they look like humans, they look like people in fursuits, not gonna lie, but I actually really like Cinderace's design. So that's so Team Score Bunny's doing really good right now. I'm interested to see what stats it has, because I know that it'll be fast. I'm not sure if it's gonna be more special or physical. I hope they don't gimp it and don't give it good stats, because that's a huge problem with a lot of starter Pokemon. Like, there are three starter Pokemon and usually one of them are good, except for in fifth gen where they were all bad. But in first generation, Charizard eventually came back, Mega Ivysaur also came back. In second generation, starters aren't really competitive. Third generation, Blaziken actually straight up just got banned. Swampert is still very good. And you can make a case for the Tree Ninja being a special sweeper that shows up and Dragon Rages everything to death. Or Dragon Pulses everything to death, excuse me. For the 4th generation, Infernape is still very good. So it's good to see that. So sometimes the starters, there's usually only one good starter. And the good starter is usually the fire type. In 1st gen, we had Charizard. 2nd gen, Cyndaquil is not very good. It's not very good competitively. It's okay. It's not very good. Blaziken, again, straight up got banned. Infernape is still very good. It's a powerful lead, powerful anti-lead, powerful sweeper. Fifth gen starters are really bad. They're not good. They're not good competitively, y'all. I'm sorry. In sixth generation, the clear winner of that was fucking Greninja. Greninja was so busted. Not only was Greninja a good Pokemon, it was a good Pokemon plus it had protein. So it was like a good Pokemon, but also it could be way better. For some reason, it's fast, it hits hard, it's special, physical, and it could hit stab. It's insane how good Greninja was in 6th gen. In 7th generation, there wasn't really a clear-cut winner for top tier starters. They were all very middling. They weren't bad by any means. They could still be used and fit in the teams. So I really hope that 8th gen they return to form with giving a good starter. I believe Cinderace is probably going to be the good one, all things considered, because of the typing, the ability to sweep teams. It'll come down to moveset. Like, if they give Cinderace's moveset like they did Flareon, it's going to be real suck. But moving on from the fire type, we're going to go Grookey gang, baby. Oh man, I am actually super excited that Grookey turned out the way Grookey did, because he could have been another Chestnut situation. Chestnut is a terribly designed Pokemon. I know what they were going for with the 6th gen starters, with the Ninja, the Rogue, and the Knight, but they could have done a better job with Chestnut, not gonna lie. So it's good to see that Grass-type starters are coming back into the fold by looking powerful, honestly. Looking powerful. Carries a big stick and a fucking drum. How boss is that? And again, it could be a tanky grass type. It's not going to fit the slot that Ivysaur does, because Ivysaur is part poison, and poison is a very, very good defensive type Pokemon and has very few weaknesses. And also, even the weaknesses that it does have, it could just tank those hits straight up. So I really hope that Grookey is a strong physical attacker with good defenses and good HP. Someone that you bring in, take a hit, and then dish it back out. As far as Grookey's or Rillaboom, I really don't actually like the name. Rillaboom, not a great name. I know what they were going for with Go Rillaboom, but it's just, come on guys, please, spare me with that. But as far as design goes, Rillaboom actually is top tier design. It is up there with the Ivysaurs and the Tree Ninjas of the world. It's far and away better than Torterra, even though Torterra is one of my favorite Pokemon. It still leaves some bounds above it. Same with the owl type Pokemon from 7th gen. I have forgotten its name. It's in my head. It's Rowlet, and then the one with the hair, and then the arrow guy. I can't remember its name right now. But as far as Rillaboom's design goes, it's very good. And I'm glad this is the direction. This was the foregone conclusion. They could have ruined it. But since Grookey's design, this could have been the foregone conclusion. And last but not least, we're going to Sobble's final evolution. It's Randall from Monsters, Inc. I am not joking. I'm sure that this Pokemon is going to be fine. I am sure that once we see it in motion, it's going to be fine. People had a lot of issues with Greninja's final form as well. Personally, when I saw Greninja's final form, I knew that Froakie was being on Team Froakie was the right choice, because far and away, the coolest water Pokemon, the water starter design. It's a freaking ninja, come on. And with Randall's design, the name of the Pokemon is Inteleon, but I'm going to be calling it Randall because that's who it looks like. They're going for a spy look with this Pokemon. It's very clear when you look at it and think about it. Even if you compare it with Spy vs. Spy, you can see it. It's just that, why does it look the way it does? They had an opportunity to turn the Salamander-type Pokemon into something a little more monstrous, a little more... It could still fit the theme of a spy, but not look like a dude in a reptile suit, because that's what it looks like. And sure, the other Pokemon, you can make the same argument for Cinderace and Rillaboom, but if I see Cinderace and Rillaboom at a con, I want to take a picture. If I see Inteleon at a con, I don't want to interact with it. It looks like a creepy guy who's going to ask you for candy, or who wants to say, hey, KK, you want some candy? Who has a white van, there's a bunch of stickers over it, filled with nothing but conspiracy theories, because he's not a very good spy. And I'm sure that we're all going to eat shit when we see Inteleon's stats. I'm sure we're all going to eat shit when we see that this Pokemon is fast. It's a very powerful special attacker. It has some of the best moves in the game. Its hidden ability is just up there with Greninja's. But right now, a very first impression of Inteleon, it is not great. It is not great. And I'm sure that this Pokemon is going to be fine. I hope it's going to be fine. I hope Team Sobble gets a win in one of these apartments, because the design is... It doesn't look like it belongs in the Pokemon universe. Even Rillaboom and Cinderace have other Pokemon that you can compare it to. Rillaboom, even if you look at... If you compare Swampert and Rillaboom, even though they're different types, they look the same. They look like they could exist in the same universe. And same with Cinderace and Blaziken. They look like they are Pokemon. They exist in the universe. No other Pokemon looks like Inteleon in this game. Even with all the other Pokemon that were leaked in the 8th generation, Inteleon looks wholly unique and not in a good way. It looks wholly unique and it's from a different game. It looks like a Digimon. And if Inteleon was a Digimon, I wouldn't question it, because Inteleon looks like it belongs in the Digimon universe. But this one, it looks out of place to me. That's why I'm not vibing with the design of this Pokemon, because it looks so out of place. It looks wrong in the greater context of the Pokemon universe. And look, I'm sure that Inteleon is going to be fine, but maybe not. It is pure water type. It has very few weaknesses. It's weak to grass and electric, I think. But if it doesn't have good stats, no one's going to use it. And once people find out that Inteleon is what it evolves to, they're going to be real mad. Like, if they don't look up these spoilers, if they don't see anything about it, they're going to be surprised because the second stage looks like a Pokemon. That's the thing that gets me so much because it goes from Sobble and then second stage is a natural evolution of it. And then suddenly it's on both. It's on both legs, it's standing upright, it's lanky as hell. It looks like it has on jeans and a jacket. It doesn't look like a Pokemon. It looks like a Digimon, and that's my main issue with Inteleon. I have spent more time on Inteleon than the rest of the Pokemon cast, but Inteleon just looks wrong to me. That's my problem with it. It's not a bad design, it's just a bad design for a Pokemon, especially a starter type. Especially something you expect people to carry through most of the game once they hit level 34 or whatever level these Pokemon evolve at now. It's gonna be kind of a gut check. It's like, oh no. This is what it looks like? But that's it for me. Let me know what you think about the new starter Pokemon coming in Sword and Shield in just a few weeks. It's a little crazy that they made it so close. They were so close to having everything be flawless and everyone be surprised. Wow, look at all these cool, literal cool new Pokemon. I want to talk about the other new Pokemon. I will in a future video, probably tomorrow. Record today, release it tomorrow, so I don't have two Pokemon videos in one day. But so many cool looking Pokemon, and then the starters, and then everything leaks, and it's like, oh wow, well this sucks. This sucks for everyone involved. I don't feel bad. This is a foregone conclusion. Pokemon always leaks, and they seem to not really know how to deal with it. But with all that said, let me know in the comments, who's your favorite starter? Are you still on Team Grookey Gang? Let's go. Or now that you've seen Cinderace, are you thinking about maybe switching sides? Which would be fine, because I actually really do like Cinderace's design. And if you're Team Sobble, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry that this happened to you. I'm so sorry that you drew the short end of the stick this generation. It has to happen every once in a while, right? It has to happen. Somebody has to draw the short straw. And the water types drew the short straw this time. Sorry, y'all. But that's it for me. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to leave your comment. If you're new here, please subscribe. But whatever it is you decide to do, whether it's like, comment, or subscribe, thank you for watching, thank you for listening, and until next time, Grookey Gang! Goodbye, everyone.